making a stink over.
The problem is, Joe, there wouldn't never been no stink if you just called, say, a week before, a day before. Said, hey, Teresa, you know, I noticed we gotta have an 8x11 sheet of paper up by the door over there before we have.
I had nothing to do with any of that.
Yeah, right, whatever.
Yeah. I had nothing to do with that. I got here.
You think anybody believe that?
Well, you know, I frankly don't care, cause I know, you know, I know what I know. I had no idea that meeting was gonna get postponed.
Yeah, may I speak?
No, no, you may not. This is a, this is.
I'm asking the chairman.
But anyway.
We have to vote.
But, you know, it doesn't matter to me whether to believe it or not.
Does,
But the thing, the point is.
Nydia would like to make a point. Does this board want to hear the point that Nydia wants to make?
I don't. We'll read it in the paper or something later on.
Nydia, is it a point that's good for the board?
I believe yes, Madam Chair.
I say yes. Go ahead. Could you turn the, your video off to make the point?
Actually, it's an open meeting, and so by law, I do have the right to have the video on.
That's fine. I just don't like you talking while you're holding the video.
I respect that. I just wanted to make you all aware that I passed out the little red booklet called Georgia Sunshine Laws, A Citizen's Guide to Open Government, at the steering committee meeting, which was several weeks prior to the meeting that got canceled. So all of you, I passed it out here at the table at the meeting. You may have been out of town that night, although I did leave a copy with Teresa for you to receive, I believe, Mr. Murphy.
Yeah, I got it that night.
Okay, and so I did give notice, and it was me by myself who walked around and looked and noticed there was no public notice posted anywhere in the building, and that is a requirement of Georgia Sunshine Law. Mr. Moses or Dr. Moses was not involved in that.
Have you apologized to the citizen?
The two that were before
this board that night? Have you apologized to them?
Because you
could have been forthright and brought the matter up and made sure we were in compliance, because we have a desire to be in compliance.
As soon as I realized we lacked compliance, I notified the planning director and the county manager. As soon as I saw it, I notified the county manager and the planning director. Yes, indeed. I most certainly notified them, and they will vouch.
Did you apologize to them?
I don't owe anyone an apologize. I don't owe anyone an apology. I have not caused the lack of posting of a public notice. That's not my requirement. I don't work for the county.
The citizens who had matters before this board, who were paying for legal counsel to be here, who were paying to try to get something done through the state. You know, and I'm all for the sunshine, but I have this suspicion that you knew in advance, you planned it, and you carried forward. And I'm fine with that. But there's a citizen who pays ultimately what you did.
Mr. Kelleher, as soon as I discovered the lack of posting, I notified everyone I could that was in the building. And that was indeed Doug Dare and Mr. Tom Brown. I wasn't aware of it, and I came to the meeting, I looked for the notice, it was under. It is not my job to post the notice. I don't owe anyone apologies. I did not fail to do any job that is a responsibility of this board.
Nydia, I think you've got your point. You got your point across.
Thank you so much for allowing me to speak.
I want to clarify something. Teresa, you didn't give the book to me, because I wasn't at the steering committee meeting. I just wanted to make that clear.
I'll give you a copy if you'd like when I have it.
Though you said that you gave it to me to pass on to Matt. Thank you for correcting me.
It was Vanessa Bernstein. Thank you. It was, you were not at the steering committee meeting. I did leave it with Ms. Bernstein to put it in Matt's mailbox. Thank you for correcting me, Ms. Cox.
I have a question for Nydia.
Yes, ma'am.
Is your reason to get us in compliance, is your reasoning for doing all this to make us a better board?
Thank you for asking.
Because that's what I'm hoping it is.
Yes, indeed. My purpose is education.
And I appreciate that.
And Roswell, and I said that all along. Roswell's perfectly educated. They don't need any help. Fulton County.
It's that kind of attitude that really doesn't help this board, Mr. Murphy.
I don't really care what you think, lady.
That's very apparent.
I really don't care.
And that's unfortunate. Because the citizens do care.
Because you're a god, apparently, right?
Most certainly not.
okay?
Close to a dime.